look forward to exploring Alfheim and not having to fight elves.
Oh? What makes you think that's an option?
They've united, haven't they? What possible reason would they have to attack us?
Sorry to say, but there are still plenty of elves out in the Barrens eager for conflict.
But why? Freyr united them. They fought together at Ragnarok.
For those who have spent their lives in combat, peace is not always an option.
I see another realm tear from Gaunt. Shall we close it?
Creature Atreus heard. It lies out in the desert.
Wonder what it could be. Most of the larger beasts of Alfheim have long been dead.
My brother would have known. Freyr loved this realm.
And the realm loved him in turn. Still does.
I'm sure he blamed me for having to leave.
That was not your fault.
I know. But I can't fault him for wanting to protect his family, even at the cost of plunging this realm back into war.
Wait a bloody moment. Is that...
Thor's hammer. And his daughter.
I'll make you proud, Dad.
Well, good for her. We never do seem to get rid of those things. Thanks for grabbing that for us.
Oh, it's real good for wood. Better for bone. Things are getting hotter. What can I do for a goblin? Just when I thought you couldn't get more godly. You need any more? Y'all know where to find me.
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Well, sure. Might not look like it, but there's loads of life out there. Just gotta know where to look.
And where would that be?
No idea. Best of luck, though!
Gulon in Alfheim.
And sled trained by the looks of it. Most unusual.
I've never seen such obedience in Gulon. There's some kind of magic at work here.
Regardless, it should make desert travel downright pleasant. Were it not for a big sandstorm. Any particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
How do you hope to find anything in all this?
Perhaps we find a cave first to catch our bearings? A tempting treasure chest! Damn the sand!
Oh!
Another one of Dvalin's diagrams.
You spoke of his conscience.
Aye. He saw that the Aesir would likely use his powerful weapons to cut down his fellow dwarves, so he ripped out his design pages and scattered them.
And what of him?
Well, the Allfather found out. He wasn't terribly pleased.
I don't see a way past this gate. Not while the storm rages. Is inside.
Whatever's inside is kicking up quite a bit of sand.
How do we reach it?
There's caves and tunnels aplenty out here. Let's find one and see where it takes us.
Ah!
That's some of Cavassier's poetry. The sky looks strange over there. Perhaps another piece of Asgard.
Careful, brother. You're covered in Bifrost.
Yeah!
We find two more.
It's almost impressive.
Entrance to the cave!
This cave extends underneath the desert.
Aye. A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple. Perhaps we'll find Atreus's wounded animal down here.
Lead the way, Kratos. I trust you to not get us lost underground.
The Twilight Stone give you the angle you need, brother.
Lashing out at everything and everyone for their fate.
They will not listen to reason. Combat is unavoidable.
Oh, trust me, I know. Still, I wish it were not the case.
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader.
This creature Atreus heard. Why wait until now to free it?
It was not a priority.
We were too busy attempting to stave off Ragnarok to indulge in any desert dalliances.
A shame. I imagine Atreus would have enjoyed a quest to free an injured animal.
Yes, he would have.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to twist the knife.
You did not. Atreus has chosen his path. I trust him to be safe.
lower angle should work. The words of the Norns repeating in my head.
Your worry consumed you, as my rage once did to me.
You overcame it, eventually.
Thanks to Atreus. And his mother.
Yes. Perhaps if Odin had loved his children as much as he loved using them, both would still be with us. Reminds me more of Freyr in his youth than of Baldur. His sensitivity, his compulsion to help any and all in need.
That is his mother's influence. Despite all attempts to train him otherwise, Atreus was eager to help lost spirits or run errands for the dwarves during our travels together.
Fae's influence runs deeper than that. Why do you think you're the one assaulting a cave full of hostile dark elves to save a wounded creature?
Excursions like this once served as training for Atreus, or an excuse to gather resources while testing his abilities. But I made him a promise. His voice as my guide.
And his voice told you to come out here?
He would approve. Strange, that means more to me now than it did before he left.
You said yourself. Atreus takes after his mother. His approval is her approval.
Seen one since I was a child.
Hey, Gefjun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half-goofer I've ever laid eyes on!
That howling sounds familiar.
It's the Song of the Sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
That must be the cause of the storm.
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
There must be a way to cut it loose.
I'd wager that there's nothing here a well-placed throw of the axe can't solve.
If we can clear those rocks away, we might get the right angle. To escape.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Half-giffers are known to burrow, so I'd hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
Even though it's bound by their hive?
Hive matter doesn't belong to the dark elves, any more than the light belongs to the light elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources, one the elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the light elves seem keen to banish the hive over on their side, the dark elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
But if this is true, are we doing more harm than good by destroying this hive?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No. Freyr would have wanted us to do everything in our power to restore this realm. We will free it.
Here! You should be able to cut this part away and free the Half-Goofa!
Never imagined I'd see a Half-Goofa fly again. Can't believe the lad missed this.
The storm is gone. The song of the sands has returned to Alfheim, albeit somewhat diminished from how I remember it as a child.
Atreus will be glad to hear it is no longer in pain.
You look forward to telling him.
One day, yes.
You gave him a gift, allowing him to walk his own path. I know that wasn't easy.
I know you cared for him as well. You have always done right by Atreus.
He is the best of us.
Well, nice to be able to have a real conversation out here for once.